We have the good cholesterol and the bad cholesterol. What's the difference?
Yeah, so it's a bit of a misconception, the whole idea about HDL is being the good cholesterol and LDL being the bad cholesterol. It depends. Some people, their particles are going to be more atherogenic because of other outside stressors, other things that cause inflammation. So some people can have the same amount of what we think of as being the bad cholesterol, and one person might be more prone to those particles being atherogenic or plaque-forming type particles, where somebody else with the same exact number won't have a problem. So there's a lot of other factors that we have to look at.
I always tell people there's no such thing as good and bad cholesterol. There's cholesterol.
Wait, stop right there, because you've just broken down everything that happens from every doctor I've ever been to in my life who always goes through good and
hence
bad lipidologists.
Cholesterol.
Right.
Exactly. So then how are people supposed to then take that? Because I guarantee that everybody watching this show has had a doctor say to them, you have good and bad cholesterol.
So again, we're being very strict. There's no such thing as good and bad cholesterol. There's only cholesterol. Cholesterol doesn't travel freely in the body. It's encased in what are called lipoprotein particles, which is what Lisa was alluding to. So the reality is the same cholesterol, if it's in a particle that's taking it out of the body, we'll say it's good because it's not getting into your arteries. If it's the same cholesterol in a particle that's going into your arteries, we'll say it's bad because it's going into the arteries where it can cause disease. So cholesterol is cholesterol, but how it travels, how it's packaged, will determine where it's good or bad. And as Lisa said, it's more than just the cholesterol. You could have cholesterol in these particles. If they're not getting into the arteries, it doesn't affect you in any negative way. So the art is how we get to the people, prevent it from getting into the artery walls, keep the cholesterol on its way out, and not let them get the disease we can't concerned about. Because there's no disease high cholesterol. The disease is atherosclerosis. The disease is how it affects your arteries.